Hi everyone! In this video, I will show you how to create a NPM package and publish locally using Verdaccio as our NPM proxy registry. This can be very helpful if you want to test your package or keep them private. If you have utility functions or components you are used to copy and paste between projects, it's time to have a more professional approach. And better than that, it can help you to organize your code, separating concerns, improving tests, and increasing maintainability. So we have three goals today. First, we need to install Verdaccio and set our NPM registry. Second, we need to create and publish our package. And third, we need to check if we can use our package as a dependency for another project. I hope you have fun. So, let's start installing Verdaccio globally and running it. If you want to know more options to install Verdaccio, like for instance using Docker, you can visit its installation page. I will put the link down below in the description. We can now access Verdaccio page from our browser. Note that if you are using the default settings, this is the URL. Let's go back to our terminal. We need to add a user for authentication. And set the registry. As I want to continue using NPM registry, I'm informing here that this registry should be used only for the given scoped name. If you prefer, you can skip this and set the registry as an option when running the command npm publish. In this case, you are gonna need to do this each time you are publishing. Now, let's take a look in the npm global config file. Note that we have our token from the authentication and the registry we have just set. Now, the login in Verdaccio should be working. So, we have reached our first goal, and we are ready to move to the next step, which is to create our package. I'm gonna create our two projects at once, the package and the client. So, let's create the local repo, then run npm init to create the package JSON. Now, we can install TypeScript and types for Node as dev dependencies. And create a default TypeScript config file. Now, let's repeat this for the client project, using a bit of video editing magic. Okay, so far we did the pretty much basic stuff to create a TypeScript project. Let's open the NPM package project in our editor. Let's start adding the git ignore file. To keep focus here, I'm not adding a README file, but you should do that in real projects to help other developers and the future you. Let's review the TypeScript config file. Here, I want to work with ESM modules. Now, we need to add two properties, the output directory to dist and the declaration property to true, because we want to generate the TypeScript data types. This is basically the minimum stuff to config. From here, you can adjust the properties according to your needs. And before jumping to coding, we are gonna add to the package.json. I'm gonna use a scoped name here. and the types property to specify the main declaration file. Just so you know, typings is a synonymous of types, so you can use either one. And don't forget to change the output folder path in main and types. Adding a basic build script. The property files informs which files are gonna be published. Keep in mind that the files README, license, and package.json are always published. The last thing here is set the property type to module, because we want to work with ESM modules, import and export. Now we are ready to start coding. To keep things simple, we are gonna create a simple type user and two functions to convert any string to camel case style. But they will be in separate folders, each one with its index file. This allows you to have a better control of what you want to really export from your project. Sometimes an exported function or type can be used only internally in your package. The user type is just to demonstrate that types are also exported. To convert to camel case, we are using a regular expression that will extract an array of words considering only letters. Then for each word, we just need to guarantee that the first letter is capitalized and the rest must be in lowercase. Then concatenate all words in a string, and note that the separator here is an empty string. The lowercase is even simpler. We need to call the function toUpperCamelCase and then guarantee that the first letter is in lowercase. And that's it. Now we just need to build and publish. Keep in mind that we need to build our package whenever we change our code. Otherwise, we are going to publish the old disk folder content. Let's visit our local Verdaccio registry and check if the package is there. Note that NPM considers the version in our package JSON. Here, we are controlling it manually, but we could use a third-party library to help us with semantic versioning. In fact, if you want to know more about semantic versioning and how to do that when publishing and employing our projects, don't forget to leave your comments about it. So we have reached our second goal. It's time to work on our client and use the package we have just published. Let's start adjusting the package JSON in the TypeScript config file. Now it's the moment of truth. Let's see if we can install our package as a dependency. Okay, we are good. Let's create a simple index file to use the user type and the camel case functions. And let's add the build and start scripts so we can run our project. Let's run it. And ta-da! It's alive! How simple and cool is that? Okay. We have reached our third and last goal. I really hope this can help you to organize your code and build better modular solutions. If you find value in this video, give it a thumbs up. It really makes a huge difference. Thanks for watching, and I see you in our next video.